So students, let us have a glimpse on the eating habits of animals before going to the next part. Let us look back, mark right for the true and wrong for the false statements. Number one, all animals depend on other animals for food. It's the right answer. Number two, there are many food chains in nature. Right. Number three, all food chains start with grass. No, not only grass, any plant or any food grains. It starts with the, but actually with the plants. Now, let's proceed further with the next part among the eating habits of animals, which is called as eating habits. Here, different animal eats different food, right? They have got mouth parts suited to the type of food they eat. Herbivores such as cows, deer, camels and horses eat grass and other plants. They have got sharp and broad front teeth to bite off the grass. They have flat back teeth. This helps them to chew their food well. Here the picture of a horse is given here. A teeth of horse is a herbivore which feeds on the plants and leaves. See the teeth over here which are sharp and broad, isn't it? So this helps the animals to bite off the grass and leaves, right? Now, observe a cow or a buffalo after it has eaten its food. It chews for a long time. If you have observed any cow or buffalo, it will be eating in a hurry while it is grazing. But when it sits and rests for some time, it removes the food that has been eaten and it goes on grazing, eating again. Cows, buffaloes and some other herbivores have an interesting way of eating. At the time of grazing, they swallow the food without chewing it and later they bring it back to the mouth and chew it properly. This is called chewing the cud. If you have observed or if you have not observed, just go to a cow shed or the place where the buffaloes and cows are tied and watch the animals eating over there. None of carnivores are such as lions, tigers and wolves. Tear and chew the flesh of other animals. They have four long, sharp and pointed teeth to tear the flesh. They have flat back teeth. This helps them to chew the flesh. Snakes do not chew their food. They just swallow the food and then they sit, relax, and it is all again digested with the help of the muscles present in the body. See here, teeth of a carnivore is shown here. It has got sharp four teeth and behind the teeth are flat and strong teeth which helps it chew the flesh of the animal. Now further, a chameleon is there catching an insect. It is seen over here. A mosquito sucking the blood, sitting on the skin of a person, and it is sucking the blood of a person here. A butterfly is seen over here which is sucking nectar from a flower. Some of them swallow animals bigger than their own heads. Snakes have small mouths, but when they have to swallow a large animal, their jaws open out and the mouth becomes very big. Lizards and frogs swallow their food without chewing. A frog has a long and sticky tongue. It shoots out the tongue to catch the insects. Just now we have seen it in the picture there above. A chameleon also has a long tongue and uses it in the same way. A mosquito has a sharp and hollow tube in its mouth. It stabs you with this and sucks your blood in the same way you drink using a straw. I think you know how to you drink juice and all using a straw. The same way the mosquitoes will be sucking the blood from our body. A butterfly's mouth is like a long and hollow tube. Similarly, like our straw itself, it sucks the nectar from the flowers because nectar is the flower for the butterflies. So it will be using the proboscis, which is in the form of a long and hollow tube to suck the nectar. Now further, do you know turtles and tortoises do not have teeth at all, but they are able to eat without without the teeth. The tube-like mouth of a butterfly is also called proboscis. Now let us revise here. You know now, plants make their own food, while animals cannot make their own food. Herbivores are animals that eat only the plants. Carnivores are animals that eat other animals, the flesh of other animals. Omnivores are animals that eat both the plants and animals. A food chain shows which animal eats what in nature, right? Animals have different eating habits. They have mouth parts that are suited to their eating habits. These are the 6 points we need to remember forever. Certain words are given over here which are called as glossary. Jaws means the bony parts of the mouth with the teeth, shoot to move suddenly and fast.